Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. Over the past 2 episodes, we've created a character using shape layers. First, we made the head of our character, then last week we gave him a body. This week we'll go over rigging using resources that are native to After Effects, which simply means not using third-party plugins. This method gives you a ton of control over your character, but it can also mean a ton of keyframes. With a little patience and a lot of creativity, you can do some pretty awesome things with this method. There's a lot to cover, so let's dive right in. Okay, so here's our character that we've created over the last few weeks. So this week, I want to go over in more depth the process of rigging your character. As we went along, mainly to illustrate a few pointers, I connected some of these layers to one another. So I'm going to highlight all of our layers and just set our parenting to none. That way nothing is connected to each other, and we can go through this one step at a time. Whenever you rig these characters, you need to go from the extremities inwards. So you'll always connect the hands upwards and the feet upwards. So let's just start at our first grouping here, which is our right lower leg. Isolate these. I named our foot layer shoe. Parent our shoe to our lower leg, and then parent our lower leg to our upper leg. Press R to bring up your rotation. If you move the upper leg, everything below it moves. If you bring up the rotation for your lower leg, it only moves from the knee down. Or if you move your shoe, it moves independently of everything else. Our next section here is our left leg. And again, we want to take our shoe and parent it to our lower leg. Take our lower leg and parent it to our upper leg. Bring the character back in. We can skip head for now and go right to our right arm. Let's parent our right hand to our lower arm. The lower arm to our upper arm. And again, we can see if you bring up the rotation, moving the upper arm moves everything below it. Moving the lower arm moves only the lower arm and the hand. And if you need to move the hand for any reason, it will move independently. And our next section here is our left arm. So again, go left hand goes to lower arm goes to upper arm. And those are all of our limbs. So now we still have some layers that haven't been parented yet. So let's go through here and correct that. So we want our right upper leg and our lower upper leg to connect to our waist layer. And then we want our right upper arm and left upper arm to connect to our body. Let's connect our belt to our waist. Then we want to connect our waist to our body. And now all we have left are head and neck. So we want to connect our head layer to our neck layer. Bring up the rotation on the neck. If you want to make his head move, you can control that by the neck. But also, if you want to move the head by itself, my anchor point, if you notice, is right here on his nose. If you hit Y to bring up your pan around tool, that actually needs to be at the bottom center of his head. And make sure all of your anchor points are set in the right places. So with that set, see, we can make his head move properly now. And so let's go to our neck, and we want to connect that to our body. So let's just go through here and make sure all of our anchor points are set in the proper place. Right lower leg is at the knee, which is right. Right shoe is at the upper left of that layer, which is correct. Right upper leg is at the top center, which is correct. Left lower leg, left shoe, left upper leg is correct. Head, we just set that. Right lower arm is at the elbow, which is correct. Right hand is at the top center. Right upper arm is at the shoulder. Left lower arm is at the elbow. Left hand, it's correct. Left upper arm is where it should be. Our belt is right dead center. Our body is right in the center as well. Waist is in the center. And our neck, actually, that one is incorrect. Let's bring that down here to where the V is. So now our character is properly rigged. All we have to do is set some keyframes. I like to separate basic movements at a moderate speed at about 10 frames apart. That makes it really easy whenever you're going through these. If you hold down shift and page down, jumps forward 10 frames. And a lot of these movements can require a lot of keyframes. The way he's positioned now, this is good for forward-facing movements. So we can make him wave, he can jump, things like that. The way he's positioned isn't really appropriate for if we want to do a walking sequence. If we want him to walk to the right, his left leg needs to be flipped, as well as his right arm. Highlight your left upper leg layer and right-click. Go to transform, flip horizontal. And we see how his leg is now faced in the other direction. Looks like there's some rotation on this. To keep it consistent, let's make his right leg also rotation at 0. Same goes for his right arm. So if we highlight the right arm, right click, transform, flip horizontal, and then just kind of play with our rotation on here to make it where it's positioned correctly. And we also would need to move this arm below everything else. See how it's crossing over his leg right here? So let's just move that underneath everything else. Looks like we need to move this arm above everything else. The main thing is you don't want these layers crossing over each other. For now, I'm just going to undo all of that and get our character back to where he's forward facing. If you add in a new null object, grab our body layer, connect it to that null, and let's rename this main control. So that way we can move our character without having to make keyframes for our body layer. And one of the things I do want to mention, the hand layers are a unique layer in that as your arms move, your hand placement will need to flip. So see, like if we were going to make him wave, once it crosses that line, see his thumb's on the wrong side. Thumb should be facing inwards. Just think about the way whenever you wave, if you have your arms straight down to your side, your thumbs are facing inward. And as your hands come up, your thumb is still facing inward. For the hand layers, I make those 3D. We have our anchor point sit right in the middle of the hands. We can control which direction his thumbs are facing by flipping the Y rotation to 180. Put a keyframe for rotation for right upper arm and right lower arm. Shift page down to go forward 10 frames. And we're going to move our arm, lower arm, and then shift page down for another 10 frames and kind of set maybe this rotation so that way it kind of does something like that. Now, as you see, his thumb is facing the wrong direction. So what I'll do is, as it comes up right here, we'll put a keyframe for his hand on the Y rotation. Go for just one frame and then swap it to 180. His thumb starts facing inward and ends facing inward. Just remember whenever the arm comes back down to swap that back as well. I like these keyframes. To return the arm back, if you copy these keyframes, Control C, Control V, and then these keyframes, Control C, Control V, and make sure that these bottom two are aligned with the last two. Highlight these, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. So that just basically reverses everything. And then again, somewhere right around here, we can highlight these two keyframes, Control C, Control V, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes, and it goes backwards. This is just a very basic movement. The purpose of this tutorial is to show you how to rig a character and to explain why it's important that they are done in a certain order. So that's it for this episode. Be sure to check us out next week, and we will continue with our character creation series. I'm including the project files below, so you can grab those and play around with the character and get in some practice. Next week, we'll go over some basic character movements, and I can show you how to give your character some personality. After that, we'll tackle Duik, a free third-party plugin created solely for rigging characters just like ours. Thanks for watching. See you next time.